When we talk about virtual globes, we actually talk about software models which represent Earth, or any other world, as a matter of fact. In 1998, virtual globe was just an exciting new idea. Discussions being made about a digital future where school children and citizens from all over the world could interact with a computer-generated three-dimensional spinning virtual globe, which would grant them access to vast amount of scientific and cultural information to help them understand the Earth and its human activities. Furthermore, this knowledge store would be free and available to all via the internet. Fortunately, many aspects of this idea have been realized. For instance, virtual globe geobrowsers such as NASA's Worldwind, Google Earth, Microsoft's Bing Maps, Esri's ArcGIS Earth. Microsoft released the first one, an offline virtual globe named Encarta, and soon after, Cosmi's 3D World Atlas followed. But it wasn't until NASA's Worldwind and Google Earth that made these types of virtual globes publicized. Some of you may ask, how do they came up with something like this? Well, the origin of this idea can be traced back to one man, an inventor, architect, and futurist, Richard Buckminster Fuller, and his geoscope. In fact, many of Fuller's ideas for the functions of the geoscope are now being realized by virtual globes. But how does one build the world?